alright, this is going to be a challenge. I'm going to walk and talk in a very muddy, boggy area just by virtue of the weather and share a little bit about a water announcement and try not to have a massive Facebook Live fail by falling over as I do so. I'm in the north at the moment on a farm owned by the wonderful, very hospitable Booth family, member of which is standing nearby, as I tell you a little bit about one of the announcements that we've made here today. And the reason we've made it here is because, of course, when you talk about the health and well-being of our waterways, you often just think about the immediate area around it. Of course, there's a huge flow-on effect from all of our activity, be it in our cities or in our rural areas, the flow-on effect down into much larger estuaries, for instance. So if we want to make sure that the kaipara is healthy, we have to track all the way back into all of the waterways that then contribute to that estuary. Now, that is the biggest estuary in New Zealand, a really important one for us, for New Zealand. If you think about it, for instance, and I use just this one example, majority of adult snapper on the west coast of the North Island, that's coming, hailing back to that Kaipara harbour. And so that's a really important estuary, and everyone wants to make sure, of course, that it's improving. So when we came into government, we had a goal to improve the health and well-being of our waterways. And there's three things that we said we felt we needed to do. One was stop the degradation. The second was then to start turning around the health and well-being of those waterways. And the third was to deal with water allocation. We've really prioritised those top two. And I'm here on a farm today where we've seen examples of an enormous amount of work that's been going in to make sure that the wetlands are allowed to regenerate and do what they naturally do. That the swales, natural little low-lying areas that might not look like a little waterland, but actually do naturally collect water and act as a bit of a filtration, that they're protected, and that you've got good riparian planting and fencing. And so I'm here today at one of those great examples of that. You can see down beyond me, actually, I haven't got my angle quite right here, but there's a beautiful wetland down behind me that's just naturally restoring and regenerating. So what we've announced today is, from the money that we put aside in the budget to make sure we support sustainable land use and our waterways, $12 million is going to go to catchments where communities are doing amazing work but just need a bit more financial support. And of that $12 million, Kaipara Harbour and the group that's working to support that waterway will be able to access that money. It's going to help support things like riparian planting and some of the more costly initiatives that we, of course, need to work with our rural communities to deliver. And when there's great leadership like what we've seen today, we really need to get in behind that. So it's a little bit of that announcement. Sorry, I can see some questions flowing through that I haven't answered. Concentrating on not falling over while I'm talking to you all, but I'll try and get online soon in the next couple of days and try and grab a few more of your questions. All right, everyone, thanks for joining us for what is, I think, an example of how we're delivering on our commitment to make sure that every river is a swimmable river, and that we're all doing our best to make sure that